Columbus, Ohio to State College, Pennsylvania as we get set for a little BTN football and a key conference clash presented by the United States Marine Corps as Maryland comes to town and takes over Beaver Stadium to take on the Penn State Nittany Lions. And Penn State takes the field to take on the Maryland Terrapins. Matt Bell and I'm Kevin Kugler. We take a look at the Big Ten standings in the East. You see Michigan, you see Ohio State, you see Maryland and Indiana in there at 1-0 with Penn State at 1-1. This Maryland Terrapin team trying to improve on a perfect start to the 2016 season. Great to have you with us today in Beaver Stadium with Matt Millen. I am Kevin Kugler. And for Penn State to make a move up in those East standings, you've got to expect to hear the name Saquon Barkley a lot today. Probably a good sign for Penn State if you do, because he's one of the best running backs in all of college football.
There's no question about it. He has unbelievable skills. And the Copley, Pennsylvania native does it a lot of different ways. He catches the ball well out of the backfield. Sometimes you look up and you go, wow, that was an unbelievable run. Gain of two. He's got it. And he's going to need all of that today if they're going to have any success.
Now, Saquon Barkley, certainly a guy who can get a lot done on the ground and perhaps in the screen game as well. But for Maryland, you saw that 4-0 record. Yeah. And it begs the question at this point in the season, just how good is this Maryland team?
Well, I'll tell you this. They're a lot better than they were a year ago, and there's a lot of reasons why. Good discipline on defense. But mostly it comes down to them scoring points in this first half of the season. They've really been on fire. And that whole thing really is tied to Perry Hills, their quarterback. He has been much more consistent this year than he has in the past. He has been relatively mistake-free. He has to continue to do that if they're going to have any success today.
And for more on the senior quarterback for Maryland, we check in for the first time today with a third member of our crew, Lisa Byington.
Well, Kevin, Perry Hills is a Pittsburgh native, and because of that, this is actually the first time that he has started in the state of Pennsylvania. Because of that, he has about a dozen family and friends here today, highlighted, of course, by mom and dad. Now, mom tells me that she hasn't missed a game of his since he was 6 years old. She texted him this morning to be a warrior. Perry Hills kind of rolled his eyes and said, that's mom. It is good to be back, but I have to make this only about beating Penn State today.
And he'll have to wait a little bit, Lisa, to get onto the field. Maryland wins the toss and has elected to defer. So DJ Durkin, in his first year at the helm of Maryland, will send his defense out on the field first, a defense that has been very solid against the run all year long, held Purdue to just 10 rushing yards a week ago. However, this is not Purdue's rushing attack. James Franklin's rushing attack features the aforementioned Saquon Barkley, and the Penn State Nittany Lions, who've won 9 of their last 10 at home, try to keep the good feeling going here at Beaver Stadium. Yeah. And we are underway in State College. Here comes Sanders. And he slips, and we'll keep an eye on that footing all day long. It has rained for a good portion of the night and throughout the morning. It's dry right now. The field was covered until about 7 or 7:30 this morning, Matt, when they took the tarp off.
And then it was just kind of light rain. But everybody's different. And here, it's important in this first series, both offensively and defensively, that you check your footing and understand if you have to change any kind of cleats or anything like that, now's the time you do it.
There's Trace McSorley, the quarterback who led the team a week ago with 73 rushing yards. That's important because we expect to see him using his feet a lot today, whether as a runner or buying time in the pocket. On first down, McSorley to the sideline. He's got Hamilton. And Hamilton out of bounds at the 37-yard line. Let's check in with Lisa Byington.
Well, guys, addressing the weather issues, both of these teams submitted about 18 to 20 footballs to the officials in the pregame. A normal day for that is about 12 footballs. They think that they will use about 12 here today for both of these sides.
And pace will be important for both of these teams as well, as Barkley gets his first carry and runs into the arms of Kingsley Opara at the 40-yard line to pick up a 3.
Kevin, we can say all the things we want about Saquon Barkley, but the whole thing in their run game is going to come down to this offensive line. It has got to be more solid than it's been.
Pitch to Barkley. A flag is down. Barkley's got a first down and more. Tight roping down the sideline into Maryland territory at the 43.
You got a flag at the 40, but I like the play calling of Joe Moorhead right here. A week ago with Minnesota, they're crowding the box. Right now, he's trying to eliminate people in the box and get his best runner in space.
Offside. Defense number 90. Penalty be declined. Result of the play is the first down.
Roman Braglio with the offsides and two big plays early for Penn State. One in the pass game and one on the ground.
There's Joe Moorhead, former head coach at Fordham, and he's just now getting a feel for where his team is, what it's really capable of, and what you can ask the players to do.
On the read, McSorley with a keep. There go the legs of McSorley, tripped up near the 26-yard line. McSorley picks up 17. Josh Woods kept him from getting more.
Okay, all they're doing right here, this is a read, and see the defensive end? He has to make a decision. He stayed inside. McSorley takes it to the outside. We're expecting to see a lot more of that with McSorley. A week ago, they didn't do that as much. We'll get more of it today.
On the read again, this time to give to Barkley, and Barkley into the secondary, upended by Woods at the 6-yard line. First and goal, Penn State.
Okay, perfect. This is exactly what they wanted to do. They have that defensive end. A week ago, they were trying to block him with Gesicki, and now you're going to see right there, Anabona 41, he had slowed down. He is not going to redirect and catch Barkley, and they handed it off to him.
Barkley again, and this time not getting much done. Shane Cockrell was there. He had 7 tackles a week ago, and he gets the stop after a half-yard gain.
Cockrell's a pretty good athlete. Keep in mind, he was taking snaps as quarterback just a year ago. He gained himself about 25 pounds. Good instincts, understands how to find the ball. He's going to have to find it a lot today with Barkley.
4 carries for Barkley for 41 yards on this opening possession.
This is what they've been waiting Barkley to do, and I think it's been a good adjustment by Joe Moorhead. They have included McSorley's feet in the equation.
McSorley on second down for Gesicki, the tight end leading across the goal line for the touchdown.
First thing you have to be able to do is get the ball to break the plane before any part of your body is down. And you can clearly see Gesicki did just that. That's the strength of what he is. Not a necessarily physical blocker at all, but he's an excellent receiving tight end.
Second touchdown catch of the year on his 20th catch overall. He's already got a career high in catches and yards this season. Tyler Davis for the extra point. And what a start for Penn State. A march from the 16-yard line, 84 yards into the end zone for the touchdown and a 7-0 lead. Joey Julius will kick it off. Likely back deep. And Will Likely 8 yards deep, out he comes. Likely with a little bit of a crease, that's all he needs, and he stopped just short of the 25-yard line by Monroe. Harry Hills, one interception in his first 4 games, Matt Millen, after 13 interceptions in 8 games a year ago. Big key to the success of this offense has been he's taking better care of the football.
Yeah, it's consistency, and he has been taking better care of the football. And you'll never have to question his toughness. His decision-making has been much better. That's on Walt Bell, the new offensive coordinator. He's done well with Hills.
Ty Johnson, the reigning Big Ten co-offensive player of the week, starts at the backfield. Quick swing pass, broken tackle as DJ Moore up the sideline, and Moore's got a first down. That looked like a play that was going to go for a loss on the play, And instead, DJ Moore was able to slip the tackle and get up the sideline for the first.
Yeah, and that's Malik Golden. And so what he's got to be able to do is slow himself down. Moore can make you miss. That's fine. Use the sideline as your friend and be sure of the tackle. Well done by Moore.
Four-man rush. Bills to the sideline. Tipped and almost intercepted. Noah Farmer diving for it, trying to make the pick. It's second down. Let's check out today's Auto Owners Insurance impact players when Maryland's on offense.
Well, they've got to get this running game going. Ty Johnson leads the team in rushing. They'll need him. Lorenzo Harrison, when he comes in, another guy has great speed. And Marcus Allen, the leading tackler, one of the top tackles in the Big Ten, 22 tackles a week ago. I'm not a big fan of that when your safety's making that many tackles, but he's productive.
On second down, Hills wants the screen. Nice catch by Ty Johnson. Got a block. And Johnson down the sideline. Johnson turns on the Jets, and he'll take it all the way for a touchdown. That's 66 yards for number six.
And that's exactly what DJ Durkin's team needed. They needed to grab a little bit of momentum back on their side. And this play comes on the feet of Perry Hills. He stretched that thing, and then the rest was 66 yards later for six. It would be 666.
Yes, it would. So Maryland will shift into the extra point formation with Adam Green, the kicker. Caleb Rowe on the hold. And we're tied up at seven apiece with 7:13 remaining in this first quarter. Ty Johnson had 204 yards on the ground against Purdue last week, 66 in the air on this play. And a 7-7 lead as Johnson and his quarterback celebrate the touchdown. Maryland feeling a little better on the sideline right now after a 66-yard screen pass from Hills to Johnson. And Johnson doing the work, his first career receiving touchdown, ties this game at 7 apiece. Sanders, the short kickoff. Sanders will field from the 11-yard line, fumbles the football. Able to pick it back up, and Sanders up the sideline gets across the 20-yard line. Good start to this ball game. Fun game so far between Maryland and Penn State. High snap, McSorley able to get it into the hands of Saquon Barkley, and Barkley tumbles down near the 24. Pickup of two, Shane Cockrell on the stop.
And one of the things that you've seen in the first four games with Saquon Barkley is he hasn't had much room to run. And when you break it down and look at it, you'll see him. He'll get like a gain of three, and it's one of the most unbelievable runs that you've seen. He can make people miss. You can count on him to beat one. Yeah.
Quick slant. Nice grab in traffic by Gesicki. You mentioned it as he gets the first down, Matt. May not be the best blocking tight end in the Big Ten, but he's got excellent hands, and we've seen it so far today.
Yeah, and you can put it anywhere in his reach. He's got a nice range. And anywhere in his reach, he's going to bring that thing down. This is nice by Joe Moorhead, what he's doing. He's separating Gesicki away from the pack inside and clearing the box out, giving him less numbers to block.
McSorley on the keep, using the legs. McSorley tripped up, but the 41 and 8-yard pickup. Cockrell on the tackle.
This is a departure of what we've seen. So they have been keeping the tight end inside and running that split zone read. Now they have him outside, and they're putting the onus back on the quarterback to make a decision and use your feet, and it's been effective.
Barkley with the first down to the 45. Roman Braglio on the stop.
So these defensive ends, Braglio on one side and Abonum on the other side, they're going to have to be good decision makers and quick decision makers, because when that ball is in Barkley's hands, it's up to McSorley to make the right decision. You have to force him to decide.
On first down, McSorley with time to the sideline, and a catch made by DeAndre Tompkins. Short of the first down by a yard, J.C. Jackson on the coverage.
Ball's coming out quick. It's coming out quick for a reason. They don't trust their offensive line in terms of long yardage throws. Let's see if he caught this thing and had control all the way through. There's the catch, and there's the control. That's a good catch.
Second and one. McSorley on the key. Nice little juke, and he's got the first down. Roman Braglio got him by the ankle. 42-yard line and a first down for Penn State.
That's what you do. And so if I'm Maryland now and I'm a defensive guy and I'm on the sideline, I'm saying, look, the quarterback, clearly part of their game plan is for him to run. I want to pound him every chance I get. Beat him into submission. If he's going to declare himself as a runner, you make him pay for it every time.
Barkley on first down. Not much running room that time. Anna Bonham able to get in on the stop of the 46.
Braglio and Bonham are the guys, Anna Bonham are the guys who've got to make the quarterback make a quick decision, and Barker. So now you go 3 by 1. They're going to spread things out, try to loosen the numbers in that box. Still have Barkley down inside.
McSorley off play action. He's going to tuck it and run. And out of bounds near the 40-yard line. Good job by Shane Cockrell holding his ground.
Cockrell's smart, but he tried to give him a Walter Payton imitation right there with that high knee. Like, there's only one Walter. I'm sorry. Cockrell was like, no, I recognize that's not Walter Payton. Well done by Cockrell. Good discipline, and sets up this 3rd and 10. So let's see how they match. It looked like they're in a cover 2 shell. They're going to try to force things underneath.
McSorley on 3rd down. Oh, pocket collapsing. He's in trouble. Gets away. McSorley now on the run. He's got the first down.
Kevin, it's a cover 2 shell, but they went man under with a 2-deep look. And what that means is that means the defender's backs are to the quarterback. And so they're going to lock on coverage, which is effectively blocked. And when that happens, McSorley senses it and takes off. Huge first down.
And a big play to end the first quarter here in State College. Tied at 7, but the Nittany Lions on the move. 7-7 in the rain in State College. Kevin Kugler, Matt Millen, Lisa Byington with you. Our entire BTN crew as we're back to work on first down. Saquon Barkley, little hesitation, finds the hole and gets to the 20-yard line. Let's go back to this last play a moment ago.
Yeah, so they are committing 8 people to the coverage, okay? This is called man under 2D, okay? And they think they're going to even help themselves by putting this guy right here on McSorley for his feet. And McSorley still beat him.
There's Barkley trying to get away, and he lost his footing. Roman Braglio pushing him out of the picture. And then the footing fails for Barkley. So now 3rd down, and that lost a couple back to the 22-yard line. So 3rd and 5 here.
And so for Maryland right here, this is a big down. If they can hold it to just a field goal attempt, they've won the series.
3rd down this year has been a problem for Penn State. 2nd worst in all college football, converting at just 25% on 3rd down this year. 0 for 2 today. McSorley over the middle. Gesicki, the tight end, with the catch right at the marker, tackled by Savage.
Now they're marking it at that spot. They're marking at that spot, and it's going to be the spot of the top official. The line's been all the way at the top. So here's the hit. And he's down. So knees are down, and the ball comes out as he rolls. So they're going to keep it right there. And that's
the first
down.
It is a first down, yep. So they got just what they needed on 3rd and 5, and the first conversion on 3rd today for Penn State keeps the drive alive. Right here. Slide down at the 13-yard line.
Yeah, they're going to mark it back to about the 12. Remember, in football now, it's where you start your slide. Not where your knee hits first, but where you start the action of the slide. That brought it back.
2nd down at 6. 3 receivers to the top of your screen. 2nd down, bobbled snap. McSorley diving down. And you wonder, with the rain continuing to fall, we've seen a couple of extra slips, a couple of bobbles. Is the rain having an impact on the footing and or the ability to handle?
Well, it hasn't in their man coverage. And so who's been the guy who's hurt him so far? It's Gesicki. And so you're going to have to get somebody with a little tighter coverage on Gesicki and get up in his face and make him see. And so he's down here, right in the slot. So I would get him a tight coverage on him because he's just running away from coverage. Now he walks down. That's smart.
Third and six. McSorley incomplete.
Much better. Now that was good defense right there. So they tightened it up. They learned on the last third down. And this time Jackson, number seven, is right on top of his coverage and is going to force the field goal. This is a win for Maryland.
So fourth down, on comes Tyler Davis, who has hit 17 straight to start his career as a kicker. It's a Penn State school record, the longest active streak in FBS. This one from 30 yards out. One of 13 kickers in FBS that entered the weekend perfect on the season. And he will remain in the perfect category. 18 straight, 10 of 10 this year, and 10-7 the lead for Penn State. 10-7 lead, Penn State over Maryland with 12:20 remaining in this first half. Kevin Kugler, Matt Millen, Lisa Byington back here at Beaver Stadium. Joey and Julius with the kickoff. It'll go through the end zone for the touchback. Here's Harrison with the carry. Trying to get to the edge. Harrison, nowhere to go. Somehow gets yardage. Picks up three out of nothing before Smith can make the tackle.
Kevin, what's even more impressive about that is they slanted that way defensively. And they strung it out the whole time. And he still was able to pick up a few yards.
Motion from Hayward, the tight end, on second down. Hills on the keep. And Hills down at the 30. Brandon Smith on the stop now. A third and five for Maryland.
But he got it to third and manageable. And so now his feet become a part of the equation to have to defend. And also your receivers outside and the back out of the backfield. And so choose your defense wisely. I'll go with a little tight man here and make him have to be accurate with the ball.
Wes Brown in at running back now for Maryland. That's DJ Moore in motion. Third down. The toss to Moore. Nowhere to go. John Reed perfectly defended.
His name said it all. It was a perfect read. It was no deception in that thing at all. He had anticipated him coming back. He went in Z short motion and landed up on the side, and Reed came in motion with him and read it perfectly.
So the Penn State defense comes up with a three and out, and Wade Lease will punt it away. Noticing a few chunks of turf starting to show up on this ever dampening field here in the rain.
Maryland also has gone to a quicker passing game.
John Reed at the 33 with the fair catch. And a timeout on the field. 10:24 remaining in this first half. The rain continuing to fall in State College. Well, you never know what you find on the sidelines. That is the designated satchel for the footballs on a rainy day. Robinson on the carry, and Andre Robinson gets nothing as we go downstairs to Lisa Byington.
Kevin, I think the technical term I was given was special football carriers here, and both managers for both teams have them on the sideline. Each one can hold about three footballs. I've been watching these managers. They've been pretty consistent. Every time the ball comes out of play, they've been switching in a drive football. And again, they'll probably use about six footballs in this half. They'll switch it out for six new footballs. They kind of joked and said, you know what we call them? Pizza bags, because it looks like we're delivering pizzas.
That's right. I was thinking you'd get a couple burgers in there too.
Second and 11. McSorley on the run. And McSorley with a first down and move. All the way inside the Maryland 45 to the 44 before Jermaine Carter can catch him. Trace McSorley picks up 25 on the scramble.
Yeah, watch Cockrell. That's his job, number two. His job right is right there. Did not get it done. McSorley, you get a little bit of juke and a big first down. They have taken Cockrell, and they put his eyes on the quarterback. His job is to run him down when he breaks the pocket. He's going to have to do better now.
31st play this year for Penn State of at least 20 yards or more. This is Allen. Mark Allen inside the 40 and down near the Maryland 37. Cockrell and Savage there on the stop.
Penn State and the interior of their offensive line are playing two freshmen. McGovern on one side, Bates 52 on the other. Not real strong on the inside. They're trying to stay away from that inside run game. It's a learning process.
Second and four. Allen again. And Allen down near a first down at the 33-yard line. Alvin Hill on the tackle.
That's going to be close. They may. They're going to give it to him.
Allen will leave. He gave Saquon Barkley a little extra breather. Now Barkley back on the field.
Now all the focus goes to 26. Just watching the tapes of the last few games, and wherever Barkley goes, he's got two defenders following him.
McSorley on the keep again. Down to the 27-yard line. He picks up six. Our doubleheader of Big Ten action continues next. The Illini taking on Purdue. Coverage will start right after our game on BTN and BTN to go. Barkley on second and four to the 24-yard line. Yard or so short. You can do and Kane combining on the stop. Six straight run plays for Penn State has him set up with third and one. Tough snap to handle. McSorley with pressure coming for the end zone. There's a flag. Gesicki trying to climb over Darnell Savage to get that football.
Savage was in a good position. I want to see this one slow because he's in a trail spot.
Pass interference. Defense number 26. 15 yards from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
He was trying not to hug him, but he looks apparently like a very huggable guy. No, he was in very good defensive position. He just had to get his eyes turned back to defend that thing, and they're going to call that arm kind of on their waist every time.
So first down and goal inside the 10.
Tell you this, they've had good coverage. They need to tighten it on Gesicki. Gesicki's been a major player here in the first half.
He's getting a breather right now. Tom Pankost in at tight end. First down and goal at the 9. McSorley on the keep. McSorley into the end zone for the touchdown.
McSorley should thank a couple of guys, and one of them is Bates up front, who did a nice job after he was admonished and encouraged. And then also Barkley drew the defense out and allowed that space to be created inside.
Tyler Davis for the extra point. And a 17-7 lead for Penn State with 6:06 remaining in the first half.
Trace McSorley's feet have been, they've been deadly here in the first half. The plan was to let him use it. And then when you get a nice block by your freshman guard, you're off and running.
Maryland's given up more points in this first half than they have in any first half combined this season. They'd only given up 14 all first half in four games, 17 today, and a big reason is because of Trace McSorley. We told you at the top of the broadcast he was going to be using his legs more, designed by Joe Moorhead and James Franklin, 95 yards rushing in the first half.
That's good stuff.
Likely can provide a spark for Maryland with a good return here. Excellent coverage by Penn State. On first down, looking for running room up the middle, and Ty Johnson finds none. Solid work by Parker Cothran up front. Terrence Davis, a freshman, in at right guard. Hills gonna scramble. Hills gets the corner, and then a big hit leveled by Grant Haley on the sideline.
And that's one that Hills can avoid. He shouldn't do that. Yeah, he's already got a little hitch in his get along after that first injury. But watch him at the end. Just get out of bounds. He doesn't have to lower his head and try to do all that. Just get out of bounds. Sets up this third down, and this is critical right here. They need to keep this drive going.
Third down and three. Two for four today on third down. Block on the edge for Morgan, but Morgan going nowhere. John Reed undercut him on the corner at the 22.
Again, nice read by Reed and a sure tackle. That's exactly what the Penn State defense needed and what Maryland couldn't afford. They needed to generate a little bit more, get some first downs. That's a nice job of good tackle of coming up nice and low, and he's happy about it.
DeAndre Tompkins with a fair catch called and made at the 41-yard line. Trace McSorley looking for more to add to that 10-point lead. For dear life is Melvin Kane, finally able to wrestle Barkley down at the 42. Even his one-yard runs are fun to watch.
Yeah, he's just special. And now you add in Trace McSorley's feet, and that's a big plus for what Penn State's trying to get done.
Incomplete. That rush coming from Kingsley O'Para threw that whole play off, and now third down.
And a smart play, just getting rid of the ball by McSorley, live for another down. O'Para has a nice rush to the inside, force it, and puts Penn State in his third and long, which goes advantage Maryland with his secondary. Again, Gesicki, he's been deadly here in the first half. Let's see if they don't go to him. He's up top, third guy in. There he is. Coverage out a little bit. They'll cover him from inside out, and they do.
Blitz coming, and McSorley's got to throw it away. And the pressure right up the middle from Jermaine Carter, and there's
grounding.
The flag for grounding.
That should be grounding. He was not outside the pocket. There's no receiver there. Excellent coverage on top of that, so they drop the flag.
Potential grounding. Offense number nine. Quarterback was in the tackle box, and there was no eligible receiver in the area. Lost it down at the spot of the foul. Fourth down.
DJ Durkin saying, where's the flag?
Yeah, he got it. And he can ask for a lot of things. They normally don't give them to you. In that particular instance, they did. Nicely done by Maryland. Now they've got to get, the first thing they have to do is get that first down of the series.
Likely. Back deep. Pressure up the middle. It's recovered at the 15-yard line. Jermaine Carter with the block and the recovery. Looks like Isaiah Davis comes up with it.
They came full bore inside. That was was really well done. Great effort. Watch them attack the inside three. And they're going to go through it. And Carter, because they attacked the inside, it shortened the corner. And Carter was able to get in there, make that block. And that's a huge play that Maryland has to capitalize on right here.
At the 15-yard line, Carter, who provided the pressure on the previous play that resulted in the intentional grounding, comes up to block the punt. First down. Hills on the keep. And Hills down to the 7-yard line. Malik Golden on the tackle with 1:23 remaining in the first half.
It's a good first down play.
Hills is hurt.
He's been playing on something hurt.
For an injured player.
They can't afford to lose him. His decision making has been very, very good this year. Pittsburgh Central Catholic player in Pittsburgh.
So now the second trip into the red zone for Maryland, and if they're to cash in, Piggy's going to be the guy to lead them. The freshman from Alabama. 6 of 12 this year, 76 yards and a touchdown. He's also run for 88 yards and 2 scores.
So you stack the box right here. You're going to trust his feet before his arm.
Second and 6 from the 7. Pigram on the keep. Pigram fighting for the goal line touchdown. A little shot of confidence for the freshman.
That was really well done, Mr. Piggy. That was really well done. Let's see if he's in before anything touches. He's aware of where he's at. There's the ball. That's 6. Really, really well done by Pigram. See if there's any knees down. He's on top. Ball's extended. That's 6. That's a huge score for this Maryland team.
And what a lift. Green's extra point brings Maryland within 3. 52 seconds remaining as Hills goes to the locker room. A little extra time to rest for Perry Hills. A 3-point ball game as we step aside for 30 seconds. Penn State 17, Maryland 14. 52 seconds remaining in the first half. Maryland able to cash in thanks to Piggy. The young freshman Piggy Pigram getting into the end zone for 6.
That little Piggy went home. I prefer the roast beef. I don't know about you.
52 seconds to go as Penn State from the 6-yard line, Miles Sanders. And Sanders breaks a tackle. Sanders with a lane. Can he get to the edge? Sanders down at the 30-yard line. No. Barkley up the middle. Secondary trip
down
to the 45.
There you are. So now you're playing for 3 right here. You don't have to try to get anything. All you have to try to do is pick up another 15 to 20 yards.
25-yard pickup there. Clock running. 30 seconds and counting. Barkley again. And Barkley going nowhere. Roman Braglio. With the timeout used, 1 of 2 remaining.
30-second charge timeout, Penn State. Their second.
That surprised me. As it gets down to the 20-second range, you know, that's where you start to throw, especially Gesicki starts to become a factor, and really Barkley out of the backfield.
Barkley over 100 yards in this first half, 103 on 18 carries.
Looks like they're gonna rush 3.
Drop 8. Gesicki and Godwin are to the top of your screen with Hamilton and Tompkins to the bottom.
Not as strong pressure. 1-3 look.
3 on the play clock. It's Barkley again. Saquon Barkley with a big opening. Saquon Barkley taking it all the way for the touchdown.
Kevin. You just hand it to that former Whitehall Zephyr and let him run to the end zone. That's the nice game plan. They got caught with a little bit of a stunt, and Barkley made them pay.
70 yards in 26 seconds. The 45-yard touchdown by Barkley. And Penn State, what an answer they have. A three-point game until Saquon Barkley took over on the final drive. 70 yards for Penn State in three plays to put seven more on the board and take a 10-point lead over Maryland into the locker room. What a finish to that first half. Maryland able to close back in on a Pigram touchdown. And then Penn State with the quick response. And Saquon Barkley with 148 yards pacing Penn State here in the first half. 24-14, Penn State with the advantage. We'll head to Chicago and join our boys in the studio when we return. Jimmy Frisbee and Leanne Liu, the homecoming king and queen for 2016. Penn State making their way out with a 24-14 lead. You saw a moment ago, Perry Hills back out on the field with his helmet as we check in with Lisa Byington.
Yeah, well, Kevin, Perry Hills, as I was observing, was really the only quarterback who was actually not warming up with Maryland. I just spoke to DJ Durkin trying to get confirmation from him, and literally out of his mouth, he said, it is up to Perry Hills if he wants to play the rest of the game. I said, has he gotten cleared? And then he kind of hesitated and said, well, we're still waiting on word on that. My observation before they took him to the tunnel, it looked like an upper body injury that they wanted to look at him a little bit more extensively to take the pads off and examine the upper body on Perry Hills.
All right, Lisa, thank you very much. And they did take him in, 51 seconds remaining. But with the helmet on, that would at least indicate, Matt, that he's going to get back on the field, wouldn't it?
He's a wrestler. He's a wrestler. He's a fighter.
Well, they don't wear helmets.
They don't. If they didn't mandate it, he wouldn't. No, I would expect to see Perry Hills.
Second half is underway. The kickoff by Julius is going to go out of bounds. Maryland will have good field position. Johnson reversing his field. Johnson, a lot of running to get 2 yards. Allen and Golden combine on the stop, and it's second down.
See Brandon Smith, number 47 in there, and he went out just a week ago, and he's back in for 47 in the middle. He's the middle linebacker. And so just a walk-on, but a very important piece of where this defense is right now.
Second down, and you mentioned Brandon Smith. He was in there with Evan Schwann to make the stop. We'll see Brandon Smith in there in weeks to come. Penn State fans are going to see Jarvis Miller in at linebacker. He was just moved to linebacker this week to help shore up a position that's been hammered by injuries.
Yeah, big third down right here for Maryland and Penn State. Maryland's got to get this first down. They have to find a way to be able to get this 7 yards.
Big run on the roll. Short toss, but well short of the first down. Morgan gets to the 31-yard line, 4 yards short, and the punt team comes on for Maryland.
So well played defensively by Penn State. They had the zone. They stayed back, let them throw underneath, and you go make the tackle and get off the field.
Wade Leese, the freshman from Australia. One of the oldest freshmen in the country at 28 years old. And Leese with a fair catch signaled by DeAndre Tompkins. He'll make it near the 24-yard line. And now Penn State back to work on offense. Barkley on first down. And Barkley pounced on at the 27-yard line by Jesse Annabonham.
And that's how you want to play that right there. Play nice and solid between the tackles, and then you have to have somebody, an overhang player, who's going to be able to handle McSorley's feet. That will be the key.
Push. Second down and 7 for Penn State. Sophomore Trace McSorley. The give to Barkley again. Slithers through an opening. Barkley with a first down. Saquon Barkley still fighting. Still churning and down at the 40-yard line. 13 hard yards for Saquon Barkley. Savage and Woods on the stop.
So this is the split. This is offset. It's going to be Gesicki coming down, and he's going to be the guy. And Barkley's going to split right in between those two. They've been running this the last few weeks with not a lot of success. This time with success.
From the 48 on first down, here's Barkley again. And a Bonham grabs him at the 46, and Barkley takes him to the 44. Pick up on the play of 4 yards for Saquon Barkley, who needs a breather. Saquon Barkley now over 150 yards on the afternoon. McSorley's over the mark gained as far as 100 yards, but he's lost yardage on sacks, so officially won't have a 100-yard day yet. McSorley to the air on second down. The sideline finds Tompkins, and Tompkins has the first down to the Maryland 37-yard line. J.C. Jackson on the stop.
Jackson had good coverage, and so Tompkins did the right thing. He came back to the ball. So you're going to have coverage, that's fine. Now I'm going to come back in the ball, and now I'm going to get this first down. I think Joe Moorhead's calling a heck of a game here today. Go.
Mark Allen, the running back. Three receivers to McSorley's right. That'll be the top of your screen, the 8th play of the drive. On first down, a little sprint out, and Allen can't pull that one in. Second down. And Saquon Barkley's breather is over. Last week, Trace McSorley, 408 yards total offense. The third most for any quarterback in Penn State history in the win over Minnesota. What a big win that was for Penn State.
He made a clutch run at the end of that game to send it into overtime.
Up 10 on unbeaten Maryland here early third quarter. Second down and 10. Barkley in trouble. And Barkley going to lose yardage. Back at the 40-yard line where Roman Braglio is waiting for him. A loss of 3.
Okay, so this is where Penn State had not been doing well up to this game. Today, on third down, they've been pretty darn good. And so right now, Maryland's got to be able to get a stop right here. Get the ball back, and it's a win.
3 for 9 on third, and you'll say, well, 33% is not great, but look where they've been all year.
Yeah, but they've got to keep their eyes on McSorley's feet. Looks like they're going that 2-shell with man under again. That means you've got to account for McSorley.
Only Arkansas State came into the weekend worse on third down than Penn State in all of college football. Third and 13. There goes McSorley on the run.
There it is.
Field opens up. McSorley diving, and he has the first down, it would appear. Just across the 27-yard line, Savage with the tackle. And just as you called it, Matt Millen, Trace McSorley's feet get the first.
Yeah, but you want to know, Barkley is the key to the whole thing, because they do have somebody accounting for McSorley's feet. And it's Jermaine Carter. But Barkley got the block. And wasn't a devastating block. It was an effective block. And it's able to get him sick.
The pitch to Barkley. Hurdles Will Likely, and Barkley with a first down. The spin caps it at the 15.
Who does this stuff? Where do you see this stuff? Hey, football fans, enjoy this. This is just freaky
stuff.
This is
timeout for an injured player.
I think they watch too many video games and think they can do it.
But he can.
He's just a freak, man. That is awesome.
That's a run you'll see at the end of the year. You know, when they're going through the all-conference teams and they say, first team all-Big Ten, Saquon Barkley, that's the run you'll see.
This is what Penn State fans were expecting, and now he's delivering.
And by the way, he gets better in the fourth quarter in his career. He averages almost 8 yards per carry. From the 15 on first down. Barkley again. Saquon Barkley, a yawner of 4 yards, and he may fumble the football at the end of the play, and he did, and Maryland comes up with it. Likely
midfield.
And Maryland gets a huge turnover.
Recovered by Maryland for a first down.
So Barkley goes from the star to the close of the show as he fumbles this one, knocked down and likely recovers it.
And that's why you keep on playing. Let's see when it comes out. Oh, Will Likely, that is just tremendous job of Likely getting on it and getting it out. It's kind of hard to see in that massive humanity.
The only thing you could see is Likely's arm pull. See if we can see it here.
Let's watch.
Watch Likely's arm yank it right there.
Yeah, so he's knocked down. So keep in mind, the call on the field is a fumble. And watch the awareness of Likely, number four. You can see him right here. And what he's going to do, get his hand in and not quit on the play. And then yank it out. You never know if he's down or not, but you take the chance. He did just that and made a huge play for this Maryland team.
It forced a 12-play, 65-yard drive that looked very much like it was ticketed for the end zone. And instead, Maryland gets the stop. And now Pigram and the offense for the Terps go back to work. Pigram on the keep on first down, and Pigram a yard to the 12. You've got a young quarterback, a true freshman in after the injury to Perry Hills, who stays on the sideline.
So Penn State's really playing for the run here. So they are going to load this box up, and they're going to say, okay, Pigram, beat us with your arm if you can.
Second down. Pressure coming. They set up the screen. Caught by Jacobs. Jacobs with a first down and a little breathing room for Pigram. Out to the 26-yard line. Allen combining in there on the stop with Brandon Smith. And Leeburn Jacobs, just his second catch of the year.
That's a nice call there by Walt Bell, the offensive coordinator. So he knows, hey, you got a young guy. Get in there. Give a nice, easy throw back underneath.
From the 19 on first down. Pigram on the keep. Pigram a little room. And Pigram out across the 30 with a first down to the 31. Let's go. Mike Hall texted me last night to let me know he was at Wrigley. Very nice of him to share that information as we check in downstairs with Lisa Byington.
Kevin, Maryland still won't confirm for me for sure if Perry Hills' day is done, but he hasn't taken his helmet off this whole third quarter. However, he is not acting like he is going to go into the game anytime soon. He's been on the periphery with all the offensive huddles. The only thing I've observed is he's been shaking out his right arm, squeezing his right hand together. I did reach out to his mom, Lori, in the stands, and she has not been told any information about the school as well.
All right, Lisa, thanks very much. On the screen, minimal yardage to the 32 for DJ Moore. Penn State sniffs that one out pretty well. Now third long.
Because what they know right now is Pickram's not throwing anything past 5 yards. So you're playing him in a probably in a 10-yard box. So you got third and nine, so you're going to keep everything in front of you. But you have to check his feet, because that's where he can hurt you. Let his arm try to beat you.
Pigram, incomplete, looking for Jacobs, and it's fourth down. If you're joining us late, this is where Perry Hills got hurt, late in that first half.
Yeah.
Hard to tell anything that happened there, although the hit on the shoulder.
Yeah.
And we've not seen him since. There are the numbers. You see him trying to loosen up that right arm.
That's going to feel a lot worse tomorrow morning.
Tompkins and Garrity back awaiting the punt from Lease. And a collision as DeAndre Tompkins, the fair catch at the 30-yard line. What if Garrity gets credit for a tackle on that play?
Well, you have to give a me call. And sometimes you both are yelling, you don't really hear.
No Saquon Barkley to start this drive. Mark Allen, the running back. He'll get the carry. And Allen unable to get away from Kingsley Opara. Good job of slipping the block by Opara and bringing down Allen.
Yeah, Opara's been solid inside. He's a big, powerful guy. And so he's anchored in that interior. They really haven't got much of the interior. Maybe occasionally on a counter, but now they put Saquon Barkley back inside, and he's looking to turn 200 yards.
He is just 4 yards shy. 28 carries, 196 yards for Barkley. Career highs in both. Go. McSorley looking deep down the sideline, looking for Tompkins. He's got it, and Tompkins will take it to the house.
Told you a little earlier about DeAndre Tompkins, about understanding how to get open. He got on top of that defender and stayed there.
J.C. Jackson was the man trying to keep tabs on him. 70 yards later, he saw him celebrating the touchdown. Tyler Davis on for the extra point. And what a way to end the third quarter here at State College. Trace McSorley going up top. Penn State came in leading the Big Ten with plays of 30 yards or more. 70 into that category here for Tompkins, and McSorley from his seat likes what he sees. Penn State leads this game 31-14. They lead this series all time 36-2-1. But when the series resumed in 2014, when Maryland joined the Big Ten, it became a tight contest. Each of the last two games determined by 1 point. So this lopsided score, a little bit unlikely, as Will Likely brings it from the goal line to the sideline and cannot reach the 15. Already had our Matt Millen throwback earlier today. Good to see another glimpse of my partner in action.
I posed for that. Didn't take me long.
You look good.
Thank you.
Good hair day for you.
Oh, absolutely.
Pigram still in at quarterback. From the 10-yard line. To Jacobs. Jacobs unable to get back to the line of scrimmage down at the 8-yard line. Brandon Smith again leading the way for Penn State.
So Smith made the tackle. Cole Farmer made the play. Cole Farmer's played a good game here.
He has.
Brandon Smith has played a good game also. Been very productive in the tackling department, but I think the perimeter Penn State's defense today really showed up.
How much easier is it for these Penn State defenders right now with what is obviously a very limited set of plays for Pigram?
It's a lot easier. And so you're saying go ahead and try to beat us with your arm like we talked about.
Pressure coming. Pigram dancing away. Pigram in trouble. Still eluding. Pigram. And Pigram down with a yard gained on the play to the 9-yard line. Schwann finally finished him off.
Schwann and Brandon Smith again. Schwann right there. Sickles got a little bit of pressure on the top side, forced it on the out. Schwann stayed there, and Brandon Smith had a really good game here today.
Third down and 11. Pigram. Wobbler to the sideline. Moore coming back, but he couldn't get there in time to make the catch. It's incomplete. And it's fourth down on the punt. Once more comes Wade Lease.
That's exactly, Kev. That's exactly what they're saying. They're saying, look, beat us with your arm. You're not going to beat us with your feet. You're not going to run the football if you're going to do it. And so, to quote Bill Belichick, is we're going to make you play left-handed. You're a righty, you're going lefty. And if you can beat us, more power to you. But we don't think you can.
Tompkins and Garrity back for Penn State. This is Tompkins with the fair catch signal and made at midfield. Penn State will go back to work with a 31-14 lead. 7:40 to play. First down and 10. There's Barkley with a carry. And Saquon Barkley eyeing 200 yards.
There's no
He's
need for him
49.
To be in there anymore. Get him out.
Well, our Benjamin Moore game changers. How about the combination of McSorley and Barkley on the ground? 48 rushes, 281 rush yards.
Well, McSorley opened it up for Barkley and vice versa.
Unofficially now 200 yards for Saquon Barkley. first 200-yard game since Bill Belton did it against Illinois for Penn State a couple of years back. Gesicki, who played a big role early, not only from a receiving standpoint, but just almost a distraction standpoint.
Yeah, and I thought what Joe Moorhead did with Gesicki was really smart. And so he eliminated and canceled out a defender by moving him outside the box. And then on second down, third down, he was key in that first half moving the chains.
And on third down, Barkley working his way through traffic, and he gets the first to the 40-yard line. And a Bonham and Woods combined on the stop.
That was all Barkley.
And one of the things that Mike talked about this week on Sports Life showed up today. I don't know why more people aren't just taking notes and listening to everything Mike says. We'll tell you that in a moment, as the give is to Mark Allen, and Allen to the 39-yard line. Now, Mike talked about last week these plays against Minnesota that eventually led to a penalty. Joey Julius gets lit up. Well, you saw it again today. History repeats itself. The kick out of bounds and the blast from Isaiah Davis that got him ejected from the game.
Yeah. Well, anytime you get a kicker who likes to get down there and try to tackle people, you're going to get blocked. Guaranteed.
The moral of the story is don't go after Joey Julius and listen to everything Mike Hall says on BTN. He can lead you through your life, people. Second and nine. McSorley over the middle looking for Gesicki. It's incomplete, and there's the flag. Shane Cockrell on the coverage.
Gesicki was trying to get to the middle. Actually, was pretty well covered. Cockrell just kind of flopped around, but not Cockrell, but Gesicki flopped
pass
around.
Pass interference. Defense number two.
Right here.
Ball be placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
So Cockrell gives him that push right there, and that's what they call. You have to account for Mike Gesicki in the passing game. And he needs to work on his run game. That's why I really like what Joe Moorhead did in getting him out of the box. That was smart.
He's out again. Top side of your screen along with two receivers. In is Miles Sanders, the freshman running back.
He's had a little bit of a problem holding on to the ball.
Sanders with the corner. Fresh legs. Sanders down the sideline. Touchdown. The cherry on top for Miles Sanders.
Did I mention that he has really good run skills?
First touchdown as a true freshman.
Well, let's just see if he's in all the way. And he is. Not even close.
What a day for the Penn State run game. It may not have been done in the same formations as Penn State of old, but similar results to Penn State of old on the ground.
Now, I got to tell you, Joe Moorhead, their offensive coordinator, I think he called himself a heck of a game. I thought he had a great game plan coming in, and I thought his play selection was spot on. And that's just gets a nice open field, and he's going to take advantage of it. And who's his biggest supporter? Saquon Barkley.
Big hug. The running back's productive today. And a lot of smiles on that Penn State sideline in a 38-14 lead.
I would have asked for a hamburger instead of that.
Maybe $10. Buy me lunch. Likely. And Likely stacked up before he gets to the 20-yard line. Aaron Monroe on the stop.
I got to tell you, this Will Likely, he's really fun to watch. And they're going to leave here with a loss, but not because of his play. Ultra competitive, great return skills, has cover skills. Now, he's not a real big guy. He's like 5'8", but that kid can play. He is really fun to watch.
And obviously, when you look ahead for Maryland, you're talking about Maryland with a healthy quarterback or experience from Tyrell Pigram, Piggy, who's out there still for the injured Perry Hills. But this team has a lot to look forward to as the season goes along. Nowhere to go with Sharif Miller in the backfield on Teldrick Morgan. But you look ahead for this Maryland squad, down 38-14, DJ Durkin in his first year, but Minnesota, Michigan State, Indiana, they've got Rutgers at the end of the year. Are there enough winnable games in there for Maryland to get to a bowl game?
Yeah, I think the answer to that is yes. I think DJ Durkin has them pointed in the right direction. I think what you're seeing right now with Pigram in here right now, this is not what they are. And so Penn State has put them in a position to just be one-dimensional right now. They won't be that.
Second and 15. A little glimpse of a hole for Ty Johnson before it shuts down at the 21.
But if you look at what they have, like, they have a stable of running backs. And that stable's pretty darn good. They're gonna need Perry Hills healthy. And Pigram will continue to develop. But he's not there right now. What they really need right now is that offensive line to come together. Because right now they're inconsistent in that offensive line, and I thought Penn State took advantage of that, particularly on the edges today. With Sickles and Schwann.
On third and 8, Pigram under pressure. He's gonna run. And Pigram down. Sharif Miller with the stop near the 24. And on comes the punt team for Maryland one last time.
DJ Durkin knows it. Live for another day. Hey, there's more games to win. I think he's a terrific coach. I think he brings great enthusiasm. I think he gives great focus to the teams. I think he's one of those guys that'll get this thing straightened out down at Maryland, and it'll be back to the Ralph Friedgen days and, you know, bowl games. I think that's on this plate.
Lease with the punt. Fair catch called for by Tompkins and made at the 33. And one thing you say about this Penn State defense is the goal this week, according to Brent Pry, was we can't let their minds tie up their feet.
Right, which was really smart.
And it seems like they were able to accomplish that.
And so what does that mean? That means we have to simplify things. That means we can't overburden them with thinking at the line of scrimmage, because it's really not about the thought process, it's about the decision-making process. So you want to try to eliminate as much decision-making as possible. They play freer, they play faster. I think Brent Pry accomplished that today.
New quarterback for Penn State as Tommy Stevens, the redshirt freshman out of Indianapolis, Decatur Central High School product, getting his first extended opportunity here on first down at the 46. Stevens on the keep, and Stevens with the first down. Now, technically, Penn State, with the time remaining, could take a knee, and if Maryland didn't call timeouts, they could run this thing out.
And they may do that.
But the experience is good as well for a whole bunch of guys who've not had a lot of opportunities.
Especially a young quarterback. And you see Franklin's talking to the officials right now about it. While they run this play.
Yes. First down and 10.
Nice day by Trace McSorley.
152 yards through the air, 81 on the ground. He was over 100 in yards gained, but he took the sacks, and that hurt the overall yardage. Stevens again on the keep. And Stevens upended inside the 25. A first down to the 22. Melvin Kane on the tackle.
Just shut it down right now.
Take a knee. So Penn State content to head out of this one with a 38-14 win over Maryland. James Franklin's Nittany Lions, very impressive in State College today.
Well, we talked about Trace McSorley, he did his job. We talked about Saquon Barkley, he did his job. And I do credit Joe Moorhead, the offensive coordinator, because I thought he did a terrific job.
All around solid effort today, and Saquon Barkley with a career high in rushing yardage and in attempts. And for DJ Durkin at Maryland, there are days you move forward and days that you go back to the drawing board. I'll go back to the drawing board after this one.
And then he'll move forward.
Absolutely. As we check in downstairs with Lisa Byington.
Well, Coach, you wanted to make the run game an emphasis, and what a day your run game had. What was different this afternoon?
I think getting our quarterback involved, Trace McSorley, was a big part of it. That's not something we had done a whole lot of before today, so I thought that really helped us. And then Saquon, I think, is running harder right now, and he's breaking some big ones.
Describe what you saw from Saquon Barkley today.
Really, to be honest with you, our O-line is getting better every single day. They're covering guys up. They're finishing blocks more. Saquon's got the ability to make people miss, break tackles. We all know how good he is. Our offensive line now is starting to give him a chance consistently.
The most rushing yards in your tenure here at Penn State. If I were to totally tell you that this team was going to accomplish that from where you have been here in the previous weeks, what were the possibilities of that right now for this team?
I love how you say my tenure. I've been here 3 years. I haven't been here very long, but I'm proud of our guys today.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Saquon Barkley, 200-yard day today to pace that rushing attack for Penn State. Joe Moorhead getting congratulations to his quarterback, Trace McSorley, who had a solid day as well. And Maryland on their way out of here with their first loss of the season. A happy running back and a happy Penn State squad today. They win it 38-14. Coming up, the Boilermakers visit Champaign for a battle with the Illini. But first, we'll head back to Chicago for a game break. For Matt Millen, Lisa Byington, Dick Koenig, I'm Kevin Kugler saying so long from Penn State University.